Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to pull together last week's data entry lesson with our previous lessons on how to build a dashboard in Excel, and we are going to build a dashboard using our defect data that we have been working with for the last couple of weeks. So today, to give you an intro to what's going to be on our dashboard, we are going to use the data entry from last week up here in the top left corner. We are going to use a slicer. I'm going to put in two pivot tables. The first pivot table dealing with a number of total defects per date. The second table dealing with all of the defects and at what time that they happened. This top graph up here is going to graph the number of defects by date. And this bottom graph down here is going to graph the number of defects by date, but also by the time that those defects happened on that date. While there's a total up here for the day, there is also a total down here by date, but it's spread out as to the time when every defect happened so that we can look for certain trends about whether or not defects are happening at the same time or different times per day, or if those intervals are close together or spread out throughout the day. So how do we get to this? Well, first of all, let's click this plus button down here and add in a new sheet. And we are going to call this one Dashboard Test and hit Enter. To save some time, I'm going to start off at the end of our lesson from last week where I've put in the data that goes into a whole new row in our data table with the button that says Add New. But moving on from there, let's go look at our end goal dashboard. Let's start by adding these two pivot tables. The first one, which tells how many defects there are per date, and the second one, which tells the breakdown of what time each of those defects happened. So if I go back to Dashboard Test and I click on cell D2. If I go to insert and go to pivot table, I'm asked to select a table or range. I'm going to hit the up arrow, go to data set, and just select this entire table. Hit that arrow again and say okay. I would like to see this by date and number of defects. Down here, instead of sum of number of defects, I'm going to click the down arrow, go to view field settings, and just change this to defects. Underneath this table, I'm going to insert another pivot table. When I'm asked to select a table or a range, I'm going to hit the up arrow, go back to my data set, select the same table, hit that button again, and say okay. This time, I would like to see the date and the time and the number of defects, but I'm going to deselect the hours. And under sum of number of defects, I'm going to hit the down arrow, go to value field settings, and again, I'm just going to pick the word defects and say okay. My top pivot table is going to give me a sum of defects by date. My bottom pivot table is going to give me a breakdown of those defects by date. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to get notifications of our new weekly Excel tips. If I select my pivot table and I go up to insert bar graph and stretch this out, I pretty much have a bar graph of the total number of defects per day. I don't necessarily want the legend on there, so I'm just going to click on it and hit delete on the keyboard. Next, I would like to insert a graph that tells me the total defects per day, but on a more detailed level, so I can see the time that each defect happened. First, I'm going to select my pivot table. Then I'm going to go to insert and insert a 2D line graph. I'm going to move that graph over here, and then what I would like to do next is insert a slicer. So I'm going to select my pivot table here and go to insert slicer, and I'm going to pick just the date and say okay. I'm returned with a list of dates, and I would like to move that list of dates over here and maybe stretch it out a little bit. So now if I click on a date, I can see that my top graph is changing, but my bottom one is not. I would like to link this slicer to both graphs. So in order to do so, I need to right-click on the slicer and go to Report Connections. On here, pivot table number 2 has been selected. But if I look at my sheet name here on Dashboard Test, I also have pivot table number 3. So I would like to check that one and say OK. So now, whenever I change the date, my defects per time will also change on the bottom graph. So if I select 723 or 715, I can see that my data is changing. If I take the filter off and I look at the top graph, I will see that 713 and 715 are problematic days. So first I'm going to select 713, and I can see both graphs change, and I can analyze the bottom graph a little bit more. I'm also going to click on 715 and see that graph change as well. I can also go over here and get rid of the legend so that I have a little bit more space. If I would like to, I could also stretch out my graph a little bit here and the one on top. And if I need to remove the filter for this slicer, I can just hit this button up here. So there you have it. This is another interactive dashboard that allows you to enter a new row of data or look at your data by date and quickly analyze the total defects per day and the detailed level of defects per day by time. Hopefully you learned a lot in this lesson, and look forward to seeing you again next week. If you have any requests for another video that you would like to see, please include that in the comments below, and we will consider putting it in future lessons. Thanks and have a great day.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions, and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.